Welcome back to my channel and welcome if you're new here. My name is Jen. I'm a certified weight loss and nutrition coach, and I'm on the WW or the Weight Watchers Blue Plan. Happy Friday. It is Friday, so it is weigh-in day. As always, I'm going to share with you this week's weigh-in, kind of how my week went. We'll set some goals for next week, and we'll go over the WW or the Weight Watchers workshop topic. I'm really liking the topics lately with Weight Watchers, and this one is no exception. So if you're excited for today's video, please give this video a big, huge thumbs up. And don't forget, if you're new or you're watching and you're not subscribed, I'd love to have you join my community. It's super simple. All you have to do is hit the subscribe button and the bell next to it, so you're notified whenever videos are uploaded. I do a weigh-in video every single Friday, so you definitely don't want to miss out. Check out the description box down below where you'll find my brand new meal planner. I just released this a couple of weeks ago and it has been a huge hit. I am almost sold out of the first batch, so if you want to get your hands on one, this is the time. Head on over to my nutrition coaching website to order. It will ship the same day and you will have the meal planner in your hot little hands in no time at all. It's a great way to plan your meals, plan your life, your grocery list, and stay on track, so definitely check that out. Down in the description box, you'll also find my nutrition coaching website where I can figure your macros and calories for you, let you know where you should fall every day to see the biggest results when it comes to your weight loss. I also offer one-on-one sessions in both 30 and 60 minute increments, so whatever you need to get a little bit of one-on-one help, I'm definitely here to help you. You'll also find links and discount codes to my favorite things and my Facebook group, another community that would absolutely love to have you. So check out that description box down below. Without further ado, we have a weigh-in to go over a workshop topic, and let's set some goals for a successful third week of February. Share with you guys how my week was. To be honest with you, 100% honest and transparent, like I always am on my channel, it was rough. It was a super, super rough week. I didn't get a lot of sleep. I had a hard time staying asleep. I fall asleep no problem, and then I'm up super early in the morning, 2-3 o'clock, and then I can't fall back asleep, and then I'm literally exhausted all day long. So that was a struggle this week. Not to mention, on Thursday, yesterday, I started my favorite time of the month. We all know what this is, and I am feeling it this month. I am just exhausted. I'm not feeling very well. My stomach has been hurting. It's been a pretty rough couple of days. I'm definitely not feeling my best, unfortunately. On a high note, I did go to Jazzercise Tuesday night. I'm going today and tomorrow. As long as I'm feeling okay, I think I'm okay to make it to today's workout. But man, you guys, it's been a rough couple of days. Starting on Wednesday, I started feeling really fluffy and bloated. I could just feel it in my stomach, and that's when I really started to feel the fatigue, and now it's just kind of gotten worse as the last couple of days have went on. So it's gonna be a rough next few days, but I will make it through, and my main goal is to not only go to Jazzercise, because working out actually helps with cramps and PMS symptoms, but also to stay on track with my food, because like you and like many of us, I am snacky, and the snacks I'm reaching for are not the healthy snacks. So my goal is to stay on track throughout my time of the month, so to come out on the other end better than I went in. So that's my goal for this next week. So before I share my weigh-in, let's go over this week's workshop topic. That is how to make your life easier by making it harder. Your first thought is that doesn't make any sense at all. And that was my first thought until I read a little bit further into this week's topic. As human beings, we always will take the path of least resistance. We're going to make the choices that come easy to us. But what if the easier choice isn't always the best choice? So we're gonna add some friction to our life and dive a little bit deeper into this concept. So let's talk about working. A lot of us are working from home right now. A lot of us spend a lot of time at our desk and in our desk chair. So this is a perfect example for the path of least resistance versus the little bit harder path that we'll reap a little bit more reward from. So the unwanted behavior is sitting in our chair all day long, all week long. So the wanted behavior, how about stacking your laptop on some books or a box and standing while you're working instead of sitting? And just to make sure you're not tempted to use your desk chair, roll it into another room, whether that be the living room, a bedroom, or another room in your house. Although we're talking about sitting at our desk, this can be applied to a lot of the behaviors that we encounter in our life. So why does this work? Why does stacking your laptop on some books or a box and standing actually work? You've added a little bit of friction to the behavior that you don't want to do, and that's sitting all day long. It makes it harder because it requires more energy. It requires more energy to stand than it does to sit. If we think about the behavior we don't want to do sitting all day, it naturally makes the behavior we want to do standing a lot easier. So to try this out for yourself, not only just again with sitting at your desk, but with other behaviors, number one is choose a behavior that you want to stop doing. Number two is pinpoint your environment and what is causing you to continue to do this unwanted behavior. And step three is brainstorm and figure out how the wanted behavior requires more energy so that it makes it easier for you to do. And a little fun fact for you, 53.9% of WW members who have had success on the program in losing weight say that they sit less than 11 hours per day. So a little food for thought there. So I think this topic is extremely interesting and very, very relevant. I know I will always take the path of least resistance, but if I mindfully think about what is the harder path, I know it's going to require more energy, but I'm going to come out a better person at the end of it, then that will prompt me to want to take the more friction path or the path that's a little bit harder. So try this the next time that you're taking the easy way out and see if you come out on the other end a little bit better off. So now let's jump into this week's weigh-in. Like I said, it's been a rough one. I'm feeling a little bit fluffy, especially Wednesday and Thursday. Those were the 2 days that I was really, really feeling it. So I wasn't anticipating a loss on the scale, and I was correct. When I stepped on the scale this morning, I'm actually up 1.2 pounds. Now, before I panicked, I really took a second and thought about the reasoning behind that. If you watch my videos and my weigh-ins, you know I've been weighing in every day in the month of February. I've been seeing a lot of fluctuations, which is absolutely normal. But this week, I've been seeing a lot of fluctuations. I'm seeing a good loss and then a really big gain and then a good loss and a really big gain. And that seems to be the pattern. And that's because my body is doing its thing as being a woman. And there's a lot of hormones going on. And chances of losing weight during your cycle is pretty slim. Now, you can do it, but it's pretty slim. And most individuals don't actually lose weight. A lot of people experience up to about a 7 pound gain during that time. So the fact that I'm up 1.2 pounds, not because of the food choices that I make, but just because of life, I'm actually okay with that. And what I'm hoping is by staying on the course with my eating, continuing to work out, that next week I'll lose that 1.2 and more and be better off than I was this week. And that's what I meant by I'm hoping to come out on the other end of this better than I went in. So I'm not upset about it. I know that it's completely normal. Do I like to see a gain on the scale? Of course not. Who does? But I also know that sometimes that's just out of our control. And this is one of those times. So again, I'm looking forward to moving into this next week and having success on the scale. So now I want to hear from you guys. How was your week? Did you gain? Did you lose? Was it what you expected? And if you're weighing in every day in the month of February, right along with me, let me know how that's going. I have to say it's been interesting, and I'll definitely let you guys know as we get later in the month what my plans are moving into March, but it's definitely been an interesting experiment this month. Don't forget to check out the description box down below for the meal planner, my nutrition coaching, links and discounts to my favorite things, and of course my Facebook group. We'd love to have you over there. I can't wait to hear from you guys down in the comments, and I hope that you have a wonderful Friday and an absolutely fantastic weekend, and I'll see you in tomorrow's grocery haul. Bye.